We would like to mention that I am Mr. Lee Kang Hee-ran. Next to me is Mr. Ernest. We are both the instructors today. Please turn off your microphone, thank you, or we might have to remove you from the room. So this is the outline of the training. So you... Please turn your microphone off, thank you. Okay, so we would like to check again. Can you hear us clearly? And can you see the presentation clearly? If yes, may I ask you to type in the chat box to confirm? Thank you very much. If your microphone is not muted, we repeat that we might have to remove you from the meeting room. So our training today, we will start with the outline of from CTSHA Project Batch 8 to the online log training. And then we also mentioned the required reports that you have to send after you finish your journey from in another country. And then we go over on how to develop your own blog, how to create your own blog using the WordPress platform. And then for the blog contents, it will be about what you should write on the blog and what you should include. And then at the end, we also provide the link to the blog examples so that you can use as a reference when you create your own blog. So for the amount of registered students, It is, as you can see, we have 200 participants from Indonesia, around 60 participants from Philippines, 17 from Thailand, and 7 from Vietnam. Total participants, we have around almost 300. Please be reminded that this training room is only able to accept 200 students at most. So if you are removed from the room, you might not be able to come back in again. So please do not, please make sure that your microphone is muted so that you are not removed from the room. Thank you. For the required report, this has been already mentioned to your teachers at your home country that you have to submit 3 reports. First is the performance evaluation form, which will be evaluated by the school. And then the second is student overall project evaluation form. This will be for you to evaluate on how do you feel about our program overall. Did you enjoy it or do you have any feedbacks or suggestion? For the third is the blog report, which we will talk about today, and we will teach you how to create a blog. As for to submit, please submit to either to your teacher at your home institution or submit directly to cteacher@cmeo.org. Please be reminded that we will not provide the certificate for those who do not submit the all required reports will not receive the certificate from CMEO. Okay, so this is the example for the certificate for the students. This is, we will share you the presentation slide later so that you can see what the example of what you will get as a certificate will be like. And then for the purposes of developing your blog, first is to be submitted to CMEO with evaluation forms. Second is to improve your English communicative skills, because when you go abroad, you will improve yourself a lot on speaking and listening, because you have to talk to foreigners, to teachers, to students in another country. But writing the blog will also improve your writing skills in English as well. And third is to record your new experience and share them with your friends, teachers, and you can talk about your internship experience.
Internet kurang bantar.
Please mute your microphone. Thank you. Here's a question, lesson that you have learned, photos and video, so that when you go back to work, you can, how do you say, it is like a diary of your own past. Now, these are the top examples from the previous C-teacher students. You will be learning how to make something like this later on. So that there will be a cover like on the image, for example, that a person is sitting on a bench, and then there will be a click read more to read article, something like that, which you can design by your own according to your preference. These are also top examples which we will share to you later. And then starting from now, Mr. Ernest will be talking about how to use how to create your own blog. Thank you very much.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ernest. I'm the representative of Samuel, and I'm going to describe you how to create a blog for those who have not any experience with blog. As you can see, there are many blogging services that are available for free, but for this training, I will explain to you how to make WordPress as it is recommended. For creating a blog itself, you only need an email. It can be Gmail, Google Mail, Yahoo, Hotmail, any email that you already have, but it is recommended to use the Gmail account since it's not only provide you with email, you can also use the Google Drive and also the YouTube account. Okay. And then okay. So this is the homepage of WordPress. Okay, this is the homepage of the WordPress. To make an account, if you don't have any WordPress account before, you can click on the Get Started button on the top right corner of the page. This is the button. And then you can fill in your email address, your username, your password.
Yes. Please mute your microphone. Thank you very much.
Okay, and then the next part, you can link to your website. Test. Sorry, we're having technical difficulties.
We have removed one person from the room because they have not muted microphone. We are sorry for the inconvenience.
Please make sure that you mute your microphone for this training. Okay. Okay. And then the next part, you can put your name of your blog. Example like this, and then you can put a topic on your blog. For example, let's say it's for travel, and then you can put more description in here, but for now you can just continue. Okay, and then you can give an address for your blog, enter the name. Like that, and then you can see there are many options here. You can pay for a special name for your blog, but for this tutorial, you can click on the free one, so you don't have to pay anything. Okay, and then you click on the start with a free site over here. Okay. Your blog has been created. It's very easy, just like that. And then if you want to start writing the blog, you can click on the write button on the top right corner right here. Okay, and then as you can see, you can put the title of your posting over here in the add title button and the add title field, or and then you can start writing on this field. You can fill in your for example, your daily activities, what have you finished on that day, your task, your experience, and etc. Okay, so for example, the title, let's say day one, fun time. And then you can put the field. For example, I want to and have fun. For example, just like that. And then if you finish your blog, you have finished your writing. Before you can publish your blog, you have to first verify your account. You can do it by opening your email. Okay, wait. So you need to log into your email first. Okay, and then you should be receiving a new email from the WordPress. This is the email. And then you can click here to confirm now. And your blog account has been verified. And by now, you should be able to publish the blog or any journals that you want to submit. The publish button should be blue at this point. But let's say that if you want to put a video in your blog, you can embed a YouTube video. For example, this is how you embed the video. You just choose a video, and then you find the share button. This is the share button. You can click the share button. And then there will be a link on this part. And you can copy the link. And then you can put it, just paste it in here. Like that. And the YouTube video will be embedded to that post that you're going to publish. Or let's say if you have a Google document, this is why we recommend you to use Google account, because you can have access to the Google Drive. You can also embed the Google data in the blog.
Me.
For example, you want to embed this PowerPoint slide into your blog. You can double click on the data and click on the top right corner. There will be three dots button, and then you open to in a new window. Okay, then you click on this three buttons again. this, and then you click the embed item. But if you copy the whole thing, this whole HTML code, if you copy it and you paste it, you see you cannot paste the embed link. The way to do this is, right? You have to copy only the link, the HTTPS, blah, 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 until the word preview. Copy, and then you can paste it. So you, I like to remind you once more, if you want to embed a Google Drive data, you don't copy the whole thing. You need to copy the exact link in the embed. Okay, and then if you're done with your post for that day, you can click the publish button on the top right corner over here. Then click the publish once again. Okay, and when you see the text day one, fun time is now live, it means that you have finished the process and the blog has been updated. This is the link for the post or blog that you have submitted. You can view post. This is the blog, the post that have you have been submitted. Okay, now I will show you if you like to design your blog, if you want to change the color, if you want to add a logo, you can do all of that in this design tab on the left corner. Yeah, you can customize, you can choose the themes. For example, the themes, there are many themes that are available. Example, let's just choose this one. Okay, and then you click the activate this design. As you can see, it's totally free. But if you want to choose the paid theme, you can also do that. But for this demo, I will choose the free one. Okay, and then if you click the customize side, you can go to a more specific way to customize your blog. You can arrange the menu. You can put widgets. You can play some music. The audio means that if someone opens your blog, it will automatically play music. You can put calendar. You can even put Google Translate, and etc. You can site identity. Here you can create a logo. You can select the icon. For example, if you choose like this picture, yes, the picture will be shown on this small icon on your browser. You can click publish, and if you click publish, it means that your blog has been updated according to your liking. For more information, everything is on the slide. As you can see, if you miss anything there from explanation, you can recheck it on the slides. Don't worry, the slides will be shared to you after this training. Oh yeah, also, let's say that you have submitted your daily blog, and you want to edit it. Okay, you can open it in the posts. And this is the one that I just submit. And let's say if you want to edit something, you can click on this button on the right corner and you can click edit. Or you can just click here. It will automatically open the block that you have just submitted. Okay, for example, if you want to add something, fun time at the mall, for example, you can click update to finish everything. You can edit it unlimitedly if you feel like you want to add something in your post. There, post updated. Customization. Okay, I think that's it. If you have any question, leave it at the chat box. Thank you. I will pass it back to my colleagues, Mr. Nathan.
Okay, so if you have any questions, please feel free to type in the chat box and Mr. Ernest will reply to your chat. And then we would like to move on to, because we learned how to create a blog briefly, we learned how to what each button will do or anything, but what about what to write in the blog, what will be included? So right now we do have some examples from the previous batch and we also include on how what you should write about it. Please wait a moment. Before we begin, please note that there are a lot of students who have their own blog and we would like to recommend that the blog for Simeo should be created, should be a new one, should not be the same the one as you are using for personal use. Okay, this is so that Simeo can evaluate your blog easily and properly so that you have a higher chance of getting the certificate. And please do not delete your blog after submission, because CTeacher project has a lot of students. There will be approximately 400 to 500 students. It will take time for Simeo to check everyone's blog. It might take months. So if you delete your blog after you submit it, then Simeo will not be able to check your blog and give you certificate. As in for the content in your blog report, what mostly you will include about daily activities or experience during your trip, your journey in another country. And for what to be included in the content, you can include many things. We have given you some examples, as you can see in the presentation slide. You don't have to include all of them. You can just include some of them, or you can include other things that might not be here, because what we are giving you now are just examples. So please wait a moment. We got a question. Oh, for the name of the domain, you can freely name it in whatever way you want. Does not have to be related to Simeo. For example, it does not have to be Simeo, CTeacher Journey. No, no need to. You can just put your name and some random number 1111 as your own blog or something. And then for what you can include, I'll talk briefly, travel experience, then activities, new friends, work, excursion, new skills, personal perspectives. Also including photos and video would be appreciated. And also please use proper English. Please do not write Bahasa. Please do not write your blog in Bahasa. We cannot read them. Sorry, how many content? As for the how many contents or how often you should write a blog, it is generally recommended that you should write a blog every day. But if not possible, then you can write one blog every 2 or 3 days, because we understand that you might not have an activity that to be put in the blog every day. So that please do not submit blog with like 2 or 3 articles. Please try to write at least 2 or 3 blogs. Please try to write a blog, one blog per 2 or 3 days. Or if you can write one block per one day, then it will be appreciated. And we also heard some complaints from the students that have been traveling before that they cannot write that block because they do not have the internet connection at their dormitory. So please be careful that please check your internet if you can write your block. If your dormitory does not have the internet, please inform the teacher at your receiving institution. For the deadline to the block, this should be submitted to senior or the teacher directly after you return to your home country. But the deadline, the deadline will be informed later. We will inform the date later to your teachers, and then your teachers will tell you later on. So moving on. So for the block content, the information that you have to include when you are writing, you have to include what, where, when, why, and who. So for the question that do you have to use only WordPress? No, you can use Wix, you can use Blogger, you can use WordPress, you can use anything to write a blog. But for today, we are just recommending for you to use WebX, and we are teaching them. Okay, so for the blog content, as for what did you do, as in what did you do today, important activities, new experience, feelings, like for example, you attended an opening ceremony at the school in another country, and then you can note it down. How was it like to you? What did you feel being welcomed by another institution? Where? So, because normally you will not just, you know, you will not just go to teach only or to have internship only. You will also have to travel to other places to learn about, to travel, because you travel to another country, you want to have some excursion. So when you have something like that, you can say, where did you go? And what about that place? Why did they take you to that place? Or why did you go to that place? And, you know, interesting facts about the place. For the video, we will send you through your email after this training, probably by today or tomorrow. And then for when did you go or do it? So basically, if you have been on a trip, you did something, then you can just describe your time. I did that. I went to this place in the morning. I had lunch at 1 o'clock, and I have been teaching for 2 hours, 3 hours, and so on. Please mute your microphone. Thank you. And then, why did you do it? Why is optional. You don't have to include, but if you include why did you do that, it will be more descriptive to your blog. I think the food is delicious because of blah, 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 we have to teach late, we have to work late. Please do not use your own blog that you have been using for the question that was typed in the chat box. Please create a new blog, because if you are using your own blog, then CMO will have, it will be harder for CMO to evaluate your blog. As for who, so for week one, you can, I had a lunch with my friends, I heard about a lot of things from the teachers from that institution, I went to pray alone at the mosque, for example. So this is the example from the students who have been exchanged before. We will briefly go to the content later, which you can get it from our shared presentation slides. But for now, this is the same article from the previous slides. Okay, so I'll read it. On Saturday, February 10, 2018, we went to a place called Baguio. We went by Pangasinan State University's bus. We departed at 4 a.m. and arrived at Baguio at 10 a.m. because we had to pick up our friends first, who live on different campuses at Urdaneta PSU, Santa Maria PSU, San Carlos PSU, they bind PSU and PSU Alumni City. After pick up our friends, we had breakfast together at Jollibee. So for this blog content, you should include what, where, when, why, and who. So in this slide, you are seeing the underlying text is about what. So we went to a place called Bagwell. This is what you are doing. We had breakfast together at Jollibee. This is what you have done also. Where? You went to a place called Bagwell. You went on a bus that picked up your friends from different campus that so on, and then you had lunch together at Jollibee. So it is basically means where did you have done something, the location. When? So in this case, the student wrote it as the date plus the day. So on Saturday, February 10, 2018, 4 a.m., 10 a.m. And you can also describe the time as after or before you have done something. For the question for the maximum or minimum of words, no, there is no minimum or maximum number of words, but it is important that your blog is not too short so that we can evaluate you more properly. As for why, so in this article, the student arrived at Bagwell at 10 a.m. because they had to pick up their friends who live on different campuses. And for who can mean a lot of things. It basically means we, our friends, together. We and our friends are the same word, but you can use like different words so that your blog is not too repetitive. Because imagine that if you have to use we every time you have a sentence, then your blog will sound repetitive. So you can change we to something else. You can change we to our friends. You can change we to together or something like that. So this is the example. As for the blog examples, this is from the students who went to Thailand from, I think it was, she came from Indonesia. Anyway, there will be a link below the slides. I will share the link later after we finish our training. So I would like just to show you some examples. These are also the examples that we have showed you previously at the beginning. There will be the link which you can see the examples and so on. This one is also example. Please be aware that please do not be afraid to write your blog. Some students are afraid that they cannot write a blog properly because their English grammar or English skills are not high or accurate. Please do not be afraid. Simeo will never disqualify someone from having a certificate, from having a bad English. We encourage you to write a blog, to encourage you to write, to use your English skills and improve it. And that is it for our blog training, for online blog training. If you have any questions, please feel free to type in the chat box. And also if you would like to have your documents to be sent to your email, please leave your email in the chat box. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Please type your question in the chat box if you have any questions. There's a question on how long should the content be of our daily blog. Okay, right now we can just show you an example. Maybe please wait a moment. So this is the example. So please mute your microphone, thank you. And then this is the example. So you see the cover. This is the cover. And then when you scroll down, you will see a lot of articles that this person has wrote or has written something. So when you click the blog, you can click like. For example, this is the example of the blog. See, this student put the pictures and then some chapters like when you're reading the news or article, similar to that. And then the, how, as for how long the article, this is how long it should be. It doesn't, we don't want to, how do you say, we don't want to limit you too much on how long it should be, because please think of writing a blog as in you are writing your own diary. So that you can just write, just don't write too short, please try to write more than 10 sentences or something like that. You don't have to write every day if you don't have time to write. Please mute your microphone. Thank you. You can write one blog for 2 or 3 days if you are not sure that you have enough content to write everything. Is there any questions? No.
Grammar.
For the grammar, as I mentioned before, that the accurate grammar will be appreciated, but we do not mind that if you do not have 100% correct grammar. We want you to write your blog in your own English. We want to encourage you to write your blog. Please do not be afraid from writing the blog because you are not confident in your English skills. If you have any questions, you can type in the chat box. When the CTSHA website will be fixed, hopefully in 2 or 3 weeks, we cannot confirm for sure because we will have to fix some websites for CDO as well, which CTSHA will be fixed later on, but we cannot confirm the date yet. Yes, you can inform, you can name your own blog informally as you want, but please do not include impolite words or informal words. This is very obvious. So that think of it that your teacher, any informalness that your teacher can read your blog. Oh yes, I would like to remind you that you have to send the blog to CEO or to your teacher. So if your blog is too informal, then we will know anyway. So someone asked if, the training, we are recording the video right now. So after this presentation, after we end this training, we will send you the recorded video, including the presentation slides to everyone later. As for how to create the the WordPress account.
He wants to repeat it.
Yeah.
Repeat the training.
Would you like to repeat?
We're sending them the video, right?
Oh right.
Yeah.
So for those who are asking for us to repeat which part of the training, you can refer to the video that we are about to send you later. And if there is any part you are not understand and would like us to explain, you can ask us now. But if there is something like complicated, like creating a new account, which we have to show you all over again, then please refer to the YouTube recorded video, which we will send you later. Any questions? I would like to remind again that if you would like to have our recorded video of this training, including the presentation slides, please type your email in the chat box. Thank you. When should we submit the blog address? You should submit the blog address immediately after you come back to your home country. You either send it to your teacher or I'll show you the slide. You either submit to your teachers or submit to cteacher@cmail.org. But if you submit to cteacher@cmail.org, please inform your teacher that you already have sent your blog and other reports directly to cmail. The blog link, yes, you can send the link through email, as I mentioned, to cteacher@cmail.org, or you can provide the link to your coordinator, be it line, WhatsApp, or you can just write the link down, give on some paper and give it to your teacher. Anything can work, I believe. We are still waiting for any other questions. Please feel free to type in the chat box. So you wait for two or more, around 2 minutes. If there are no more questions, we will close the training room in 2 minutes so that we can go back and send you the recorded YouTube link. Yes, the blog, the training materials, including the presentation slide and recorded YouTube video, will be sent to your email. So as long as you put your email in this chat box, you will get them. We will try to send them by tonight, if possible, because we understand that some of you are traveling tomorrow. If not, we will send you by the early morning. So since there seems to be no questions, I would like to close our training here. So thank you very much for attending our training. If you have any other inquiries or any concerns, please email to secretariat@cmeo.org or cteacher@cmeo.org. Okay, can we have the top blocks of batch 7? We are not sure yet, because our website is not fixed yet, so I don't think we can provide you some examples at the moment. I will give you the links from the examples that I showed you before. Please refer to your chat box. The links I posted are from the examples that I show from the PowerPoint slides, which you can click on them. Okay, so if you do not have any other questions, we would like to remind you that the blocks in our presentation slides are not top blocks, because we have troubles with accessing the top blocks because our website went down 1 or 2 months ago. So, but the block. I can assure you that the blocks that are in the presentation slide are good examples for you to read or refer on what should be written in the blog. So if you do not have any questions, again, I would like to thank you everyone who joined this online blog training. We wish you to have a safe journey abroad, and we hope you have fun being abroad, teaching in other countries. Thank you very much for joining the training. If you do not have any questions, you are please feel free to leave the room. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Matrusun.
Kamsha.
Thank you.
Makasih.
Kamsia.
Thank you very much.
I muted everyone.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
And yeah.
Sawadika.
Thank you. Thank you. Oke, okay, 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Very much.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We'll be
close. Thank you.
Can I just close this?
As best you always.
Oh, you give me the post.
What's the limit?